We can create purchase schedules by calculating the required amounts of raw material. Things like the scrap quantity and yield rate are factored in the calculation of the required amounts. In addition, we can also create purchase schedules for raw materials that take into account required amounts, inventories, and stock on order. Let's create a purchase schedule for the raw materials for molded parts. First, add the raw material items in the integrated master editor. Add P1 in the input instruction for component 1. Add P2 in the input instruction for component 2. Add P3 in the input instruction for component 3. Add P4 in the input instruction for component 4. In the item table, set automatic replenishment of purchase orders for P1 through P4. The item type is raw material. Set the auto-replenish flag to yes. The obtain method is purchase. Let's make the purchase lot size max 1,000 to make purchases in 1,000 kilogram units. Purchase lead times P1 and P2 are 2 days, and P3 and P4, 1 day. Let's reschedule. The purchase schedules for raw materials P1, P2, P3, and P4 have been created. Next, calculate the required amount, factoring in the yield rate and scrap quantity of parts. In the integrated master editor, set the yield rate of component 1 through component 4 to 0.8 and the scrap quantity to 4. Let's reschedule. The production quantity of molded parts is calculated factoring in the yield rate and scrap quantity. The production quantity of component 1 per manufacturing order for product 1 increases by 30. Therefore, if there are 5 manufacturing orders for product 1, the production quantity for component 1 is 650 pieces. The required amount of raw materials is calculated accordingly, and the quantities of the purchase orders also increase as a result. In addition, the inventory and stock on order are also factored into the purchase schedule. Register the inventory and stock on order in the order table. The inventory and stock on order for raw materials P1 through P4 are added. The type of order for inventory is inventory absolute inventory. The type of order for stock on order is inventory fluctuation inventory. Let's reschedule. A schedule to reserve inventory and stock on order and purchase the shortfall portion has been created. If there is an inventory of raw materials, it will be input to the injection molding process. If the inventory of raw materials runs short, the stock on order is used. If the inventory and stock on order run short, a purchase order is generated. We can see that there are no work delays caused by raw material shortages. The operation bar is color-coded based on the reservation destination for the raw material to be input. Operations that reserve from the inventory are colored green. Operations that reserve from the stock on order are colored yellow. Operations that reserve from not yet ordered purchase plans are colored red. Green operations can be started immediately, while red operations might be pushed toward the future. Color coding the operation bar based on the reservation destination allows easy checking. In this way, purchase schedules can be created according to the inventory status and taking into consideration the yield rate and scrap quantity.